our Fielding faculty and graduates. Thank the Fielding trustees who are with us today, and they honor us with their presence and shows their commitment and dedication to the university. I just would like to call them by name: Karen Bogart, the chair of the board; Patricia Zell, our secretary; Maria Sanchez, a trustee; and Dr. A.G. Green, a faculty trustee. If you would all just please stand. Thank you very much for being here. For one reason or another, I know that some of you wondered on some days and nights if this day of pride, honor, and completion would ever be realized. As one of the graduates said, they came into the room, they said, "Well, I'm still here, and I'm graduating. I made it." That day is here, and you are surrounded by a global community of witnesses, Fielding faculty, staff, your colleagues, classmates, your family and friends, who are all joyous for all that you have accomplished. I'm honored to serve as the president of this distinguished graduate school dedicated to adult learners in the social sciences. And over the years, it's been humbling to be surrounded by faculty who are leading scholars themselves and engaged practitioner scholars in clinical psychology, in media psychology, and infant and early childhood development. And I'm also a little in awe of our Fielding students and all that you bring to your studies and accomplish, often against many odds. And at the same time, I'm still inspired, very much so, by your determination and commitment and your willingness to do the hard work and the compassion that you show each other every day. Because I'm a president of Fielding, there's an assumption I'm also a clinical psychologist. And although clinical psychology is Fielding's oldest and largest academic program, it is not my field. It is an accident of circumstance. But Fielding's distinguished faculty have had to claim a historian and political science as their president, political scientist. To their credit and my gratitude, they treat me very well. I must admit, though, that psychology is a bit of a mystery to me. I come from a mechanically minded family with a father and four brothers who were all professional fixers. That is, they're mechanics. To me, the workings of a machine seem easier to understand than the workings of the human mind. From my perspective, to undertake the underlying explanations of why humans think and do what they do, or to grasp how to shift the trajectory of children and families coping with complex situations, or to reveal to people how their behavior is shaped by media and external influences, is daunting. And I know that I'm not alone in thinking that humans are a bit mysterious and complex. That includes ourselves. We are mysterious, sometimes even to ourselves. All of these thoughts prompted me to reflect on the intersection of history, my field, and that of psychology. For centuries, history, at least from a Western European perspective, was really seen as the study of the powerful, which meant mostly political. But in more recent times, there's been a shift away from this emphasis on power and dominant populations to study things that include and reveal the motivations of all humankind in diversity and complexity. So one's the Annales School, which was founded by a group of French historians around the turn of the last century, has as its core a view of history which seeks the widest possible perspective on historical changes. So this particular set of scholars focuses on all of humanity and its complexity, psychological, cultural, economic, environmental factors. For example, it examines the lives of ordinary people. That means us, I think, and the social and economic forces that shape our lives, and uses records to try to figure out what has life been like for human beings over the course of time. Others, such as Howard Zinn's germinal work in U.S. history, most notably the People's History of the United States, sought to show that historians need to dispel those dominant narratives to include the multiplicity of the human experience. These scholars call for dismantling and decolonizing of old assumptions and create deeper understandings by centering the lives of people of color, of indigenous people, and try to reveal the systemic ways in which people have been divided throughout the course of time into in-groups and out-groups, marginalized and centered, discriminated against and privileged by the different kinds of stories we tell. This has been a welcome shift in the field of history, and it's made me appreciative of a similar shift in psychology. No longer dominated by a Western European view of what constitutes a particular set of paradigms, contemporary psychologists, including our students and our faculty, offer a plethora of diverse worldviews, inclusive perspectives, and tools to help people cope with the everyday stresses and pressures that come living, that come with living in this particular world. And it occurs to me that it's the discipline of psychology that really helps us cope in a complex world. Jaime Cassio, the futurist and anthropologist, talks about this world, and he calls it a Bani world, and that's B-A-N-I. B stands for brittleness, that systems can be more fragile than they appear. A stands for anxious, that every choice appears so complex and difficult that sometimes human beings feel helpless. N is nonlinear, that means we don't always can figure out the cause and effect of things. And incomprehensible, we try to find answers, but answers don't make sense. And there's so much information out there. And when you think about it, the graduates today in the fields of study that you're in, at some level, think about each one of these elements. It's the discipline of psychology in all its forms that will provide the tools for the world that Jaime Cassio describes. Brittleness can be met with resilience and flexibility. Anxiety can be eased by empathy and mindfulness. Non-linearity needs context and flexibility and creativity. And incomprehensibility asks for openness and intuition. So this intersection of history and psychology reveals this lesson. Like the sum of our parts, we are all stronger together when each of us is resilient, empathetic, flexible in mind and spirit, self-reflective, and intuitive. These are all qualities that enable us to realize our potential. This is the promise of psychology in all its forms. So, School of Psychology graduates, I'm so proud to stand with you today. And my hope is that you have learned at Fielding from your professors, all that you have learned and all that you have learned from each other will guide and be a source of strength to you on the tough days you will experience in your lives and inspire you on the good days. And on this special occasion, and as you prepare for what comes next, Chinese philosopher Lao Tzu reminds us that your own positive future begins in this moment. All you have is right now, and every goal is possible from here. So thank you for venturing out into the world, confident in what you know and what you can do and need to do. All of us will be better for it. So now to the main event, as I'm standing in the way of listening to all the wonderful stories from our graduates, I turn the proceedings over to Dr. Brian Cutler, Program Director of Media Psychology, for the presentation of the graduates. Thank you, everyone, and welcome.
Let me begin by extending a warm welcome to all on behalf of Dean Christine Jacquin, who unfortunately could not be here with us today. I have the honor of explaining how we will proceed with today's ceremony. You will see that our graduation has several elegant rituals. You may have noticed that our faculty attire is a little different than our daily wardrobes. We proudly wear our robes in honor of our graduates and guests, our disciplines, and our traditions. The attire is explained in your program. Graduates will be invited to the program, to the platform in the order listed in the program, beginning with our master's graduates in media psychology, and proceeding immediately to the graduates from our School of Psychology doctoral programs. As each graduate comes forward, our stage marshal will hand them a lovely rose and diploma cover. Then the graduate will be hooded by their program director, dissertation chair, mentor, and will have their photo taken. In addition, we invite each doctoral graduate, after being hooded, to step up to the podium and give a few prepared remarks before returning to their seat. We wish we had more time to hear from each graduate and their mentor, but we are blessed with many graduates, and we want to leave time for for them to celebrate with their friends and family tonight. As each graduate returns to their seat, we ask that the next graduate come forward to the podium in order to minimize downtime. Graduates, you may remove your mask for the photo and while addressing our audience. Please settle in for a long ceremony this evening. If for any reason you need to step out of the room, feel free to do so. We understand and we want you to be comfortable. Last, we wish to honor all of our graduates, some of whom were not able to be with us today. All of our graduates are listed in our program. So without further ado, I will invite our first graduate to the podium. I welcome Jordan Alexander Brown to our community of scholars. I welcome Christopher H. Batchelor to our community of scholars.
I welcome Dr. Bueno to this community of scholar practitioners. Okay, gotta hurry up. Imagine being 30 years old, just having lost your husband, left with two little girls to care for and not wanting to leave your country, but knowing deep inside that if you stay, your girls could miss out on unimaginable opportunities. So you do it. Chase the American dream, not for you, but for those two little girls. That was my mom, crossing the border so we could cross the stage. I am here because of you. Mom, gracias por todo lo que usted ha hecho por nosotras y por su apoyo. Espero que esté orgullosa de usted misma, porque dejó todo por sus hijas y quiero que sepa que es mi héroe, inspiración, y la quiero con todo mi alma. I am also standing here today because of my husband, Johnny. While I was away attending classes, away on weekends, working on homework and papers, he was at home with our two daughters, and without your support, I could not be here today. And for that, I love you, and thank you for allowing me to chase my dreams. And to my family here today, my sisters, thank you for your never-ending support. To my two hearts, Maya and Mari, and I am sorry. I am sorry for all the time I spent away from you to chase this dream, and I can only hope that one day you can look back and know that because of you two, I am forever inspired to be the best version of myself and hope that you can be proud of this achievement. My loves, know this. You can achieve anything you set your mind to, and I will be right here by your side, pushing you. And lastly, thank you, Fielding. Although this concludes my journey with you, it will be an experience never forgotten.
Thank you.
welcome Dr. Kodama to this community of scholar practitioners.
As I reflect on my journey at Fielding, I am grateful for so many things, like the time I received two cans of chicken soup and a note from Dr. Ira Glavinsky, my chair, that read, "This special chicken soup will improve your health and help you get to a completed dissertation in record time. Just one tablespoon a day. Best wishes from a man who knows what he's talking about." The road to my PhD is paved with so many encouraging moments like this one, and my heartfelt appreciation goes out to all the faculty and staff for sending students soup when we need it most, and for nurturing us to our potential as scholars, practitioners, and future change makers. Through Fielding, I have found a community that truly embodies the saying, "If not you, then who? And if not now, then when?" A special thank you to my committee members, Dr. Glavinsky, Dr. Robinson, and Dr. Constantine, for your unwavering support and enthusiasm throughout my experience, and to Dr. Jeanine Craig for your steadfast presence and for reassuring me that I was never alone on this journey. To my parents, thank you both for teaching me that there is always more to learn and room to grow in life. And to my husband, Justin, who is my rock and my safe haven, to my son, Ryan, who is my biggest cheerleader, and to my family, who is all here, I couldn't have done this without all your love and support. And to my son, Jackson, who inspired my journey, thank you for teaching me what it meant to be brave in finding your voice and for reminding me that it only takes one voice to make a difference. Thank you.
Welcome Dr. Lourdes Jones to this community of scholar practitioners.
I'm not very good at multitasking, obviously. Just thinking as I reflect on my journey through Fielding, I thought about my faith, my friendship, my family, my fellowship, and my future. So just faith, I couldn't have done this journey without praying and perseverance, which definitely guided my journey. My friendship, I couldn't have done this without my best friend, my husband, you know, who kept me going, and especially, you know, just helping me talk about the literature out loud, and it helped me process everything. So I got him a t-shirt that he got an honorary PhD. And we're definitely, along the way, we're blessed with our son. There he is back there, the loud one, but that's okay. He was just letting us know that he was here. And then our little one, I have a brand new baby, so if you saw a cute little two-month-old, that would be mine. But putting my degree to work and, you know, watching them just develop, you know, infant and early childhood development, that's what our degree is in, and I get to watch it every day, being a parent, which is amazing. And just to my families, you know, help me be who I am today. Provided me with the ambition to actually pursue this journey. My fellowship, learning with wonderful professors, you know, and my fellow students, and the families that participated in my study. I learned so much from all of them, and it impacted me tremendously. And last but not least, my future. I take the knowledge learned through my Fielding journey with me each and every day as a parent, as a professional, and as a person. And just remembering that both, you know, scholarly information as well as experiential information is, you know, important in life. So I just want to say thank you, especially to my family.
Welcome Elizabeth Austin to our community of scholar practitioners.
Wow. First, I want to thank my family, and especially my husband, Dave, for their love and support. I also want to thank my committee, Dr. Josh Fetter, Dr. Devin Kassenheiser, Dr. Shelley Lane, and my student reader, Annie Wolverton, for their expert guidance, patience, and support. Dr. Deb Sussman and Annie Wolverton graciously helped me video code, and members of the Fielding Incubator Group kept me going through the dissertation process. Thank you. Finally, I owe profound gratitude to the clinicians and families who participated in my study. I started graduate school more than 10 years ago in an unaccredited program established by the Interdisciplinary Council for Developmental and Learning Disorders and Dr. Stanley Greenspan. The program focused on understanding and verifying parent-mediated developmental and relationship-based interventions for children with developmental and behavioral challenges. At the heart of this multidisciplinary model was the importance of connecting with others. Starting graduate work as an older student in an unaccredited program required that I take a leap of faith that the ICTL graduate program would become accredited. In 2015, when Fielding acquired the program, I felt like I had found a home. At the first Fielding IECD graduation, I spoke these thoughts on behalf of the ICDL students. At Fielding, I felt valued, I felt I grew as a scholar, and I made lasting connections with others. Connectedness became a recurring theme in my studies and the focus of my dissertation. After many years, my dream has finally become a reality. As I said in 2015, I would like to thank Fielding and my fellow graduates for reminding me that when you believe and connect with others, you need not fear taking a leap of faith. Thank you.
Graciela Rodriguez Garcia, I welcome you to the community of scholar practitioners.
I'm going to start with a few words in Spanish so my parents are able to understand. Hace recientemente escuché una estadística que solamente el 2% de personas en Estados Unidos tienen un doctorado. En México es el 0.01%. Muy pocas personas llegamos hasta aquí, y yo lo estoy aquí porque gracias a ustedes. Mami, papi, este logro es de ustedes. Ustedes se merecen el mayor conocimiento, el trabajo que he puesto yo en mi primaria, secundaria, maestría, doctorado, no se compara con todos los sacrificios que ustedes han hecho al dejar su país, a venir aquí a Estados Unidos a aprender un nuevo lenguaje, y a todo el trabajo que hicieron tan pesado durante todos estos últimos años. Ustedes dos son las personas más sabias, trabajadoras y excepcionales que yo he conocido en toda mi vida. Ustedes son mis mejores maestros. Lo más hermoso de llevar este doctorado es que le daré honor a ustedes dos al momento en que me llamen doctora Rodríguez García. To my brothers and sisters, brothers-in-law and sisters-in-law, I own you who I am. Thank you so much for your unconditional support and all the strength that you have given me. To my nieces and nephews, Uli, Arnie, Natalie, Sami, Gisme, Yoser, Josué, Odniel, Yadier, Jaciel, Alexander, Jimena, and Yahaira. Being your tía is the most important role that I have. I love you so much, and I promise that I will be with you in each of your graduations. You are the future doctors. To my partner, you had 1,000 reasons to leave this relationship, but you decided to stay. Thank you so much. I love you. I love you so much. And Mary, you keep me alive during this program. You are family. Thank you. Thank you.
Jennifer Bell Smith, I welcome you to the community of scholar practitioners.
Thank you. When I thought about the best way to reflect on my fielding journey, I realized that the changing quotations I put on the bottom of my email signatures throughout my fielding years provided a perfect reflection of my thoughts, my struggles, and my triumphs. I would like to share a few with you. It's good to be curious about a great many things. Fred Rogers. Thank you, Fielding, for the opportunity to follow my passions and interests and work to feed my curiosity. Do your little bit of good where you are. It's those little bits of good put together that overwhelm the world. Desmond Tutu. Thank you, Fielding, and especially Dr. Josh Fader, and the people of the Palestinian Child Institute for inspiring me to choose a project designed to make a difference in the world. Next, to quote Donald Winnicott with something that most of us in the IECD program have probably worked into at least one paper, there's no such thing as a baby. He was saying that a baby cannot exist on her or his own. A baby needs the care of a family without whom she or he cannot survive or thrive. I am here to say, there is no such thing as a PhD graduate. This is a journey I never could have survived and thrived through on my own. I want to thank the amazing faculty here, the professors who gave their time, knowledge, and heart, with a special shout out to Dr. Jenny Edwards, who started me on this journey on the right foot and kept encouraging me throughout. Dr. Deb Sussman,
where was she?
Oh, Dr. Deb Sussman, who went the extra mile to lead me to excellence in both my clinical and academic work. Dr. Janine Craig, who came on board and exuded support through her very pores. And Drs. Mary Warren and Josh Fader, as well as my fellow woodpeckers in the research incubator, who patiently led and supported me through an incredibly arduous dissertation process. But most of all, I want to thank my family, my mom, and my sisters Ellen and Rebecca, who are examples of strong, intelligent women following their dreams and passions. My children Joshua and Julia accommodated me, helped me, loved me, and provided me joy through this very long process. And above all, my husband Brian, who has been my rock, my wonderful patient support through everything that I have done in my adult life. I look forward to finding out what the future holds as a PhD graduate and now a new member of the Fielding faculty. One last quote. You don't have to see the whole staircase. Just take the first step. Martin Luther King, Jr.
Josetta
C. Tomei. Welcome to the community of scholar practitioners.
Tony, I think I already lost the bet. I didn't write anything down because I'm sick of writing. This journey has been Kristen, my beautiful, wonderful children. If it had not been for you, I wouldn't have finished. I want you to know that you can do anything you want to accomplish, and you can be anything you want to be. Tony, you have it, okay? My mom's crying. Please don't cry. My husband, Dan, who had it not been for him, this would not have been possible. He supports me through every endeavor I ever want to take, as odd as it is. Oh, I want to buy a blowtorch and start burning silverware in my garage. Go for it. Oh, I want to do a PhD. Go for it. Thank you. I appreciate you loving me for me. And my mom, I wouldn't be here without you. You were the strongest woman in my world always, and you took care of us no matter what challenges. So thank you. My in-laws who are here to support me from far away and always love me for who I am. My brothers who are not here, unfortunately, but they're my rocks. And for intern the inside the proverbial fielding walls, my committee, Devin Kassenheiser, amazing gentleman who supported me, Jenny Edwards, who was there through thick and thin, Corinne, who came here and helped me through some tough times, Dr. Janine Craig, who has talked me off of many ledges. Thank you. And my external, Dr. Walter Gilliam, who was the reason, sitting in one of his presentations, was the reason that I applied for a PhD program, and now full circle is here tonight to support me and has been there every step of the way. You have changed my world, and I promise to do great things. So thank you all.
Mimi D. Tong, I proudly welcome you to the community of scholar practitioners.
I would like to say a few words in Vietnamese for my family sitting out there, flying all the way from Vietnam to my graduation today. Lời đầu tiên con cảm ơn Chúa đã cho con sức mạnh để mà con được học hành. Lời thứ hai con cảm ơn mẹ đã lúc nào cũng muốn con trở nên tốt đẹp hơn, hoàn hảo hơn. Lời thứ ba, em cảm ơn chồng đã tin em và luôn luôn ủng hộ em làm những gì mà em muốn. Anh tin bản thân của em còn nhiều hơn em tin bản thân của em. Mẹ cảm ơn voi, mẹ cảm ơn bơ vì đã ở bên cạnh mẹ, mặc dù lúc nào mẹ cũng làm việc. Okay, so first of all, I would like to say thanks to God for giving me the strength and determination that for to pursue the journey that I've been doing. I would like to say thanks to my chair, Dr. Kathy Vlasman, who cannot be here today, for still meeting me twice a week, twice a month, I'm sorry, to inspire me to bring DIR back to Vietnam to serve my Vietnamese young family, young children and families. I would like to say thanks to my mom for always loving me for who am I, for who I am. And I would like to say thanks to my husband who's sitting over there who constantly believing me in me more than I believe in myself.
It is my great honor to welcome Dr. Evelyn Wedge to the community of scholar practitioners. Okay, so sometimes I procrastinate, and it turns out I procrastinated getting emotional about tonight. I should have done it earlier, so I apologize. I like literally lost my breath when Janine said that. So I want to start by thanking my family. They're not here tonight, but they're watching from Atlanta. So Kristen, Brad, Faith, Andrew, Ethan, Kate, even our dog Josie, because she left her hair on top of my Tam, so I wouldn't forget her. So, and also my husband Bernie, who, you know, he works for a company where people retire early because they work super hard their whole life. So he was looking forward to retiring. And then I said, guess what? I think I want to get a PhD. So all those plans he had for us were put on hold. So thank you so much, honey. I love you and I appreciate your support. I also want to thank my mom, who left us far too early and was not able to reach her dreams, but her ever-present love and support helped me reach mine. I want to thank the committee, my dissertation committee, who's awesome, Ira Glavinsky, the chair, Tracy Topple, my external reader, Dr. Rachel Oblath, my methods person, and also to all the faculty who have just been amazing. And thank you also to Janine, who she's a neighbor of mine in Georgia. Well, you know, maybe 40 minutes away, but always there for support and guidance. I also want to thank the cohort. We were here 4 years ago, and here we are. And it's just so amazing. So love you girls. Also, lots of friends that have supported me through these years, and just so very thankful for all of them. So like Jennifer, I'm going to quote a great philosopher, Mr. Rogers, who said, there is something of yourself that you leave at every meeting with another person. And I think that's so true. And I know that I wouldn't be here without all of those pieces that people gave me through the years. So thank you very much.
Welcome, Mariel Sekola Swan, to our community of scholar practitioners.
To begin with, I want to acknowledge all the backstage spouses, children, and pets who weathered the trials of a dissertation. I would like to thank my husband, Mark, who was a constant positive force, and he also manned many dinners and bedtimes solo while I did my work. Beyond the day-to-day with my family, I've had limited social interactions apart from my dissertation-related reunions. And for me, this was online meetings with my committee members and participating in the research incubator. For those who don't know, the incubator is a group of students that come together weekly to support each other's research. These students became my friends, and they encouraged me over the course of this process and through many reiterations of my project. I'm offering a heartfelt thanks to my committee, Dr. Josh Fader, Dr. Kathy Platzman, Dr. Deborah Sussman, and Dr. Aubin Stamer. Dr. Sussman, who's here tonight, was tremendous fun to work with. She has a wonderful sense of humor, and she was just as excited about my findings as I was. She also spent hours upon hours working me through the nitty-gritty of form and format. I would like to end by expressing my profound gratitude to Dr. Josh Fader, sitting behind me, who hatched and continues to nourish the incubator students. Josh, along with his faithful canine companion, Charlie, who attended all of our meetings, met with me weekly for years, whether I had made progress with my dissertation or not. He provided everything from technical help to the most fundamental forms of emotional support. He supported me as a researcher and as a new mom as I tried to support parents through my research. I would not have made it through this process without him. As I told him, I'm celebrating finishing this dissertation while at the same time grieving the loss of our meetings together. But I am determined to stay in touch with my research team and friends to pass the learning and love forward. I'm honored to stand here today, and I offer my deepest gratitude to you all.
It is with my honor that I welcome Dr. Talia Bragg to the community of scholar practitioners.
So I have a huge group with me today, and one of them is a professional cheerleader, so. I didn't actually have a speech prepared today. I've already thanked everyone individually by name to them. But I do want to share some reflections on my time here. Before I do that, I want to say thank you to the dais, President Rogers, my faculty advisor, Dr. Marty Kranzberg, my dissertation committee, including my chair, Dr. Harris Britt, Dr. Alan Cornelius, Dr. Daniel Holland, Dr. Christopher Edwards, and posthumously, Dr. Hope Landrin, the executive board of the Black Student Association. Thank you to my friends, past and present, that believed in the reality of today. Thank you to the faculty that provided a path. And thank you to my mom, Lillian, who gave me joy. Yes. And thank you to my grandmother, Versi, who gave me hope. I started this program in 2016, and if you do the math, half of the program, my tenure has been during the global pandemic, and also to the civil rights renaissance that has been occurring since 2020. What else is there to say after that? I've already spent a lot of time speaking to these things in whatever plight here within Fielding and wherever I have been graced and blessed to be. And so have you. Whether you were a student or not, think about what has transpired. Graduates, students, faculty and staff, if you made it this far, you, me, we are unstoppable. As Congresswoman Ayanna Pressley, who is now the constituent for where I live now in Boston, she once stated, if we can be a part of systems that harm, we can be a part of the systems that heal. Remaining within the scope of social justice, may everyone in this room use their education and their lived experiences to destroy every institution and system that inflicts harm. Thank you.
Well, I'm very pleased and proud to welcome Dr. Tara Chase to the community of scholars.
Hi, I'd like to thank in no particular order Dr. Lindsay Kahn for her continuous support, even for things that were not in her job description. Kendall LaPorte, most of all for her help passing the ECCC Westland internship, but for so much more. For my boyfriend Jim, for his unending support, even for things he didn't completely understand or agree with at times. For my friends and family that I know always support me. It's my part of my determination, ambition, and perseverance that have helped me be where I'm at today. I'm glad to say that I'm at the end of my formal training journey with Fielding, including a 2-year rigorous postdoc in neuropsychology, and I'm a practicing clinical neuropsychologist today. Thank you.
Thank you.
with my great honor that I welcome Dr. Albert Chan to the community of scholar practitioners.
Oh, okay, I don't believe in prepared speeches, but I had to prepare one because if I didn't, I wouldn't know what to say. Okay, so I'm incredibly honored to receive this, obviously, and it's really more than I ever hoped to achieve, and it's definitely a dream come true, but I did not do this alone. First and foremost, I want to thank my parents, James and Kathleen. They're here, right over there, taking photos. Without them, I would not have been able to do this, absolutely could not, never could have done this, so thank you so much. I was very fortunate to have many, many wonderful mentors at Fielding. And today, I'm especially fortunate to have my whole committee, as well as my faculty cluster leader here as well. So I want to thank, firstly, I want to thank Dr. Emick. When she first interviewed me, I didn't believe in myself, and really, I did not know if I would even be in clinical psychology. She gave me a chance. I don't know if she ever realized it, but I appreciate it more than she will ever know. Ugh. Also, I want to thank my whole committee, obviously, for supervising my dissertation, but there are more detailed remarks. I want Dr. April Harrisburg to know that I don't only appreciate you for supporting my research, but also for your very practical and sage advice about and perspective on life. Many times I felt I lost perspective, and she was very important in reorienting me back towards that. I want to thank Dr. Polito and Dr. Vivian as well. They have shining intellects, and really they taught me to think clearly and more beautifully than ever before, and that's a compliment I do not offer lightly. And now I carry their support and their gifts with me as I move forward. Though they're not here, I do want to thank my clinical mentors, especially Dr. Mark Rader in New Jersey. He taught me a way of doing neuropsychological assessment that I hadn't thought of before, actuarial assessment specifically, and he gave me a lot of advice as an older neuropsychologist on his way out on what a life like this would lead to and how that would be in the future. I want to thank him personally on the stage. I also want to thank Dr. Mark Watson. He was my former mentor, and he also enabled me to make a great dissertation on mild traumatic brain injury. And also, currently, I want to thank Dr. Ricky Ladowski-Brooks. She has believed in me at many times when I did not believe in myself, and she has offered me a great postdoc training opportunity with her. And I want to thank her, even though she's not here, and I know she'll be really excited to know this. And lastly, my partner, Mufan, who is in the green hair over on the right over here. A lot of us have been through the program, and a lot of us have experienced a lot of loss throughout. I always wanted someone that would stand by my side, even when I did not think much of myself. And you always stood by me. You didn't criticize me, and you stood there and you stayed with me, and I'm proud to be here with you. didn't expect this. Okay. So lastly, for my peers, I want to say this. I know it's been very long. I know it's been very difficult. But there's a reason we are here. There's a reason that we made it. And we stand on solid ground. Don't forget that.
I'm here in place of Dr. Sherry Hatcher, who could not be here tonight. We're honored to welcome Dr. Alexander Klorek to the community of scholar practitioners.
My dreams brought me here. Not just those dreams typical of a graduation speech, but also those of a world we enter when we cast away our waking lives. A world that consumes me with curiosity and wanderlust. A world constrained only by the limits of your imagination and your experience. a world that serves as a mirror into who we are. Dreaming became the topic of my dissertation. There have been many times and many challenges that have led many of us to feel as though we are walking down the boulevard of broken dreams. We have faced not only multiple collective traumas, but have also seen remarkable resilience and an opportunity for renewed hope. I saw this particularly during the pandemic and its aftermath, where mental health workers were faced with a world that had been turned upside down and inside out, with many clients seeking out our help for the first time. We had to maintain and instill that hope and the dream of a better tomorrow. I was encouraged to see that mental health treatment was being rapidly destigmatized, but we still have much work to do. Through hope, I have been given the faith to be accepted into a program in a field that fills my life with meaning. Through hope, I am with all of you now. Hope is my favorite four-letter word. Thank you, Dr. Sherry Hatcher, for your hope. Unfortunately, she is not here tonight. But thank you for your hope and helping making this dream come true, for your kindness, passion, and our mutual interest in helping others understand their dreams. Thank you to Dr. Cornelius. Where are you? Can't recognize anybody with all this stuff on, right? He served as my research specialist of my dissertation and made sure that I got the most out of my data. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Hawkins. There you are. For your feedback and guidance as a professor as well as a second reader on my dissertation. To my family and friends, thank you for your unconditional support in helping making this dream come true. Thank you to all those who consistently asked, "So when are you graduating?" Bless your hearts. To professors and supervisors, this is an oath I would like to take comprising the pearls of wisdom I have gained from all of you that I will forever carry with me. I wish to prepare a home in my heart in order to be able to invite others in, to be at the service of others and use my knowledge to fight those forces of behavior that diffuse responsibility onto others or blindly obey authority, to live and promote a life filled with meaning, acceptance, and forgiveness, even when it is hard, to understand that when one helps another, both become stronger, to promote acceptance and understanding of our emotions, how to use them productively rather than suppress them to only come back with a vengeance, to always think of others' best interests when a difficult ethical decision must be made. That's from Dr. Sherry Hatcher. To remember that even when someone is not physically present, they can be present in the minds of others and to serve as guidance. Though we no longer share the same physical world, to my professor and supervisor, Dr. Stephen Ruffins, thank you. To foster a comprehensive understanding of how physiology and pharmacology interact with psychology, thank you, Dr. Joan Reed. The mind and the body are intricately connected. To remember and never underestimate the therapeutic relationship and our work as akin to the sacred. That is dedicated to Dr. McNulty, AKA Dr. Sunshine. This is for you. Thank you, Dr. Sunshine. And thank you, could we say thank you to this beautiful weather that we've had? I mean, I've heard it's been pretty bad. Now this, I'll take this. All kidding aside, thank you for sharing this moment with me, and thank you for helping make this dream come true.
with my honor that I welcome Dr. Tawana Crosby to the community of practitioner scholars, scholar practitioners.
Tonight, I come here flooded with emotions. Emotions of joy, sorrow, and confusion. I'm exhilarated to have come so far in my journey. What a challenging, stressful, but yet wonderful experience. When I began this journey 6 years ago, I could not have imagined that I would be standing here before you today. Becoming a doctor has been a lifelong goal, and now I can say I have accomplished this goal. Heart-wrenching sorrow reminded me of the fact that many of my closest friends I have met along the way are now embarking upon different paths in their lives in other parts of the country. Now I can only hope that we will cross paths at workshops and conferences. Yet, at the same time, confused and uncertain about what the future holds. But I am confident that this experience has prepared me for whatever I will encounter in my career. Fielding Graduate University was with me the entire time, and I could not have wished for a better experience. As I stand here today, I cannot believe it has finally come to an end, but I'm glad it has. I want to thank my Fielding mentors, professors, and my dissertation committee, Dr. Christine Jacqueline, Dr. April Harris-Britt, and Dr. Joe Bush, for their unwavering support during my time at Fielding. You have inspired me, supported me, guided me, pushed me to my fullest potential, but most importantly, believed in me when I didn't believe in myself. This journey would not be complete without my family, who helped push me through this difficult time. To my beautiful daughters, Chaz and Sage, I could not have done it without your support. The tireless hours of revisions, edits, and Grammarly checks, and always understanding when I could not attend your lacrosse games, PTA activities, and Jack and Jill events. And to my wonderful, supportive husband, Ken, you rock. You have been the rock in our family for the past several years, always holding things together, never becoming unplugged, and despite your demanding work schedule, showing up for the girls when I wasn't able to be present. I would be remiss if I didn't extend a heartfelt gratitude to my family back in North Carolina. My mom, for her unwavering sacrifices and inspiration for my success, and my late grandparents, for their powerful prayers and undying dedication to my education. I want to thank everyone for being a part of this journey. And to my fellow peers, best of luck to everyone in their future endeavors. Thank you.
In my defense, I wasn't prepared to like go down that low. Thank you.
All right, let me introduce you.
Yes.
I would like to welcome to the community of scholars Abigail Marie Hafer, Abby, on behalf of myself and Dr. Christine Jacqueline, who was her research chair.
Okay, so I'm one of those people that I wrote my speech 14 times, and I threw it out the window, so I'm just going to wing it now. I just want to thank a lot of people, but before I do that, I want to say that I am so proud of all of the graduates here, because the thing is, when I went to kindergarten, I was told I was a stupid child, and I basically would never amount to anything. And obviously, I'm standing here today with 33 other amazing people, or at least all the people here, plus the people in the program, and I want to say that no matter the limitations that anything or anybody puts on anybody in this room, please go after your dreams, because you can do it. You can achieve what you want, no matter what anybody tells you. And I am partly living proof, and all of my other graduates that are sitting here with me are exact living proof of that as well. And then all of the faculty behind me are also living proof of everybody that has accomplished their dreams. So first off, I will go through, I want to thank my faculty, everybody at Fielding. Honestly, you guys have honestly been this has been the most supportive school I've ever been in my entire life. And it has been a dream to get this degree, and I want to thank my chair, who's not with us, Dr. Christine Jacqueline, and my second chair and faculty advisor, Marty Kranzberg, and then also Dr. Ray Hawkins. Without these three people, I don't know if I would have made it through this program. These three people have been so amazing, along with the rest of the faculty of the school, that they really showed you can achieve anything. I also want to thank my family, my mom and dad and sister, and then my brother-in-law for putting up with all of my stuff and the crying and the moaning and groaning. My husband, who has also put up with a lot of stuff, and my two best friends that are also here with me today, Val and James, my husband Eric, my mom, like I said, my mom and my dad. Sorry, I'm really bad at this. I should have wrote probably it down, but I just, like I said in the beginning, I was told that I would never amount to anything, and that's what makes this so amazing. And thank you to everybody, and please, if you have a dream, please go for it, because I know that, like me, the limitations people set on you, don't believe them. You can achieve anything you want. Thank you.
It is with a lot of pride that I welcome Dr. Daniel Ignacio to the community of scholar and practitioners.
Systems, right? I think I reflected in virtually everyone who's spoken today. Is success does not happen in a vacuum, right? People don't operate independently of a system. Family, thank you, my ma, pops, gaves, mentors, really, fiancés, hi baby, right? And so, yeah, and My time at Fielding has really showed me that aside from like the foundations of clinical doctoral study and clinical psychology, brain behavior relationships, and all of the APA nuances in formatting that all changed with the seventh edition, it really has been such an honor and a privilege for me, because through Fielding, I've been able to secure positions as certified brain injury specialist at St. Jude Medical Center's Brain Injury Network, clinical neuropsychology fellow, postdoctoral fellow at UCLA's Brain Sport program, and the TBI Advisory Board elect vice chairman for the Department of Rehabilitation in the state of California. And of all of those, the most meaningful to me is my identity as a survivor of 15 years of a traumatic brain injury and a month-long coma. So for those of you who know, my GCS was 3 at intake. I had a T3 Tesla MRI showing cerebral edema on my right frontal lobe, which is still there. And I have a SPECT scan showing that I have cerebral vascular hypoperfusion on that same area that correlates with my structural abnormalities. So, to say, not having a fully functional brain does not preclude you from success. Absolutely. And it is, quite honestly, everyone here saying it is, there's so many other factors to consider: your support systems, your family, your mentors, your loved ones. And through that, I mean, clearly here to say psychology has so much to offer what medical science just frankly can't answer. And from that, I stand here with all of my graduates. What a privilege and a blessing and a gift to be here to accept this hard-earned degree in front of our loved ones. And I'm so proud and honored to call all of you my colleagues. Thank you.
It's truly an honor and a pleasure to welcome Dr. Jessica Krumans to the community of scholars.
Hello, everyone. Good evening. Thank you for being here. I stand here today grateful to so many. First, I'm grateful to the women who protested and agitated for the right to education. I stand on the shoulders of their courage and sacrifice and acknowledge that this fight is not over in many parts of the world. I'm grateful to my family, especially my mom, who taught me to write with excellence, even when I really, really, really didn't want to learn that. You prepared me for Dr. Kramer's many, 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 many comments and feedbacks. I am also grateful to my sister Jocelyn, who has supported my journey in countless ways. I am grateful for Fielding's greatest gift to me, my dear friend Christy Nudge, whose constant wisdom and support has been just a phone call away for the last 5 years. Most importantly, I'm grateful to my husband Chase. I met him a week after orientation, and I told him that if he wanted a future with me, there was a lot of poverty and exhaustion in my future. And he stayed anyway. He moved across the country for internship. He listened and held me when I raged and cried over this process. Chase, I could absolutely have done this without you, because I am a badass. But I could not have done it with my humanity intact. I would have been so much harder. You have kept me a person, and I appreciate you. I finished my degree in 2021. This is the fourth time I've tried to come and graduate. So I've had a few months to think about what it means to be a PhD and what I learned at Fielding, and whether achieving this education was a good use of my time and my money and my gray hair and my overall health. And so far to me, to be a PhD is to grapple. It's to grapple with ethics, with systemic injustice, with burnout, and with hierarchy, with my own biases, my own white fragility, my own avoidance. When I started working as a supervising psychologist last year, I felt like I had, without warning, been switched from Nerf guns to firing live rounds. People would repeat things that I said, both good and bad, and I was just shocked that anyone listened, much less remembered anything. I kept thinking, since when does anyone care what I think? It doesn't matter. I'm a student. But I'm not. Practice is over. We aren't interns anymore. It matters who we are as PhD. It matters to those we train, those we teach, those we treat. Grappling is more important now than ever because the doctorate means that our words have power, our decisions affect people, our opinions are voiced in rooms where things happen. With this great power comes great responsibility. Let's use it well. Thank you all.
I'm very proud to welcome Dr. Christy Nudge to the Community of Scholars.
Okay, so I'm a rule follower, so I'm like hard on the 2-minute mark. So I didn't get to thank as many people as I wanted to, but I'm speaking in generalities. So I'm not sure what has felt more impossible, completing a doctoral degree or finding what to say right now that accurately captures what we've been through over the last 5 and a bit years and how grateful I am for all the people who supported me along the way. When I started the program, I had a goal of becoming a humble PhD holder. Now that I've earned the degree and understand what it took to complete it, I find myself telling everyone I meet that they need to call me Dr. Christy. As much as I value the degree, I also cherish the relationships that I have built with faculty and students. I really couldn't have done it with the program without them. I especially want to thank Dr. Jessica Krumans for being my person in this program. Your friendship and ability to find creative ways to motivate me have been instrumental in me graduating today, and it may have involved withholding birthday presents and locking me in rooms until I finished and sent a draft of my dissertation. I would also like to thank my family, the only people less humble than me about my earning a PhD. I have such amazing parents and siblings who have cheered me on the whole way, never making me wonder if they were proud. My mom has given so much of herself to fill in the gaps at home when I couldn't be there through internship and so much more. And last but definitely not least, my husband Alan and kids Miller, Everett, and Brielle. We have done this together. We have sacrificed so much to get here today. I love you all so much so, that I won't make you call me Dr. Christy. Thank you.
I'm here today in place of Dr. Ruth Ellen Josselson, who could not be here, but I am thrilled to and honored to welcome Dr. Raja into the community of scholar practitioners.
So when I reflect on my decision to begin the doctoral program at Fielding, a combination of brave and stupid come to mind. After all, I was a seasoned master's level clinician, I had established a strong reputation in my professional community, and I was doing the work I loved. However, I also felt empty, and I was really bored. So, I showed up at Fielding. Being here now, years later, tells me what my emptiness and boredom was about. I had carefully crafted a life that was seen as acceptable by others in my life. My previous life was not brave or stupid. It was a compromise of myself. Now here today, I recognize myself as a strong clinician and a researcher, and also as a creative, a thinker, a writer, and a believer. Parts of myself I had unknowingly stowed away in favor of the compromise. The combination of brave and stupid filled the emptiness and relieved the boredom. With the utmost gratitude, first and foremost, to my parents, the late Dr. and Mrs. Raja, to my husband David, who married me when I was 1 month into the program. David, I'm sure you had no idea what you were getting into, but thank you. To my son, Ajay, who started telling me when he was 7 years old, he's now 33, he kept saying, "Mom, you should do it. You can do it. You can be a doctor." So much gratitude to all the Fielding faculty and the amazing staff. I know you don't get acknowledged, but we appreciate you. With special gratitude to my faculty advisor, Dr. Jessica Emick Siebert. Jessica, you are the master at knowing how we should sequence our courses so we can make it to this podium. Thank you. To Christine Jacqueline, who welcomed me into the program through the post-bac program. She always gave me quiet support, and I so appreciate it. And to Dr. April Fallon, Dr. Ruth Ellen Josselson, and Dr. Margaret Kramer for recognizing the need for research on South Asian women and supporting my dissertation. Because of all of you, I hope to continue to meet life with just the right combination of brave and stupid. Thank you.
It is my pleasure to welcome to the community of scholar practitioners, Dr. Lakeisha Sharp.
No speech, just appreciation and gratitude. AG, Dr. Nelson, Dr. Onafade, and Dr. Field. My wonderful faculty advisor, Dr. Emick, and Dr. Bendel, who got me through a very pivotal part of the program. You guys know what I'm talking about. Carolyn Sharp, Eunice Sharp, Mal Payne, Clifford Pinckney, and family, God, and my wonderful partner, Richard. Thank you.
On behalf of Dr. Sherry Hatcher, we'd like to welcome Dr. Courtney Shoemaker into the community of scholar practitioners.
So I am not a procrastinator by nature, but for someone who devotes most of my time to communication and language, I could not find words for this. They don't always come easily. So writing this speech, I decided that if I didn't know how to go forward, I'd start by going backward, because I'm not psychodynamic at all. So don't worry, I'm not going to tell you my entire life story, but I will tell you a little bit about my parents, who are here today, obviously. So my mom is quite proud that she's here today. And what she might not realize is that she's the one who taught me to do things that scare me. So, like going back to school, because she's the one who did it first. So it was her that inspired this. And it was my dad who showed me what a true partner looks like. So when I met a man who immediately, enthusiastically supported me to do this program and just told me to go for this dream, I knew what love looked like. And I should give a shout out to his parents who are probably watching on YouTube, because that's what they would do. You raised an amazing man and an amazing father. So, to my husband, Dan, I love you so much. You know when to listen, when to challenge, and when to joke, like when I'm about to cry. You are my heart. So these are the people who helped me get here. But it was my mentor that kept me here, that kept me going. Now, she's not here this evening, but many of you know that my PDS and I have been working on a quilt for her. My square says, "You are the piece that made the difference," because she is. She is the reason I chose Fielding. She is the reason that I not only survived, I do have friends here to thank for that, but she is the reason that I thrived in this program. She taught me who I want to be as a clinician, as a teacher, as a supervisor, as a mentor. She taught me who I want to be as a human being. And there are not words that exist that could ever express my gratitude for knowing her. So thank you to Dr. Sherry Hatcher. Okay. I wasn't gonna cry. Okay. Last but not least, my daughters are here today, one of whom sat through orientation when she was 4 months old. Here. So Ella and Riley, I'm talking to you. I'm up here because of you. I did this for you, to show you that it is never too late to go for your dreams, and that if you surround yourself with love, with family and friends and mentors that you cherish, you will thrive. I hope I have shown you how much joy that learning can bring, almost as much as you've given me. And I hope to show you that, baby girls, you can do hard things. This was the hardest thing that I have ever done, hands down. The easiest, though, that was loving you. Thank you.
Totally need this tissue.
I'm standing in for Dr. Christine Jacquin, and it is with my great honor to welcome Dr. Holly Summers to our community of scholar practitioners. Thank you.
Wow, that definitely took the breath out of me. Thank you. I waited so long for this day, and it feels really good to be here with all of you. As my girls would say, we're so glad this is finally over. As I reflect on my experience, the biggest thing and the most rewarding part that we've all kind of mentioned is just how much the support has meant from everyone. And so many, my family and my friends, and my acquired Fielding family, friends and faculty, thank you all for believing in me many times when I did not believe in myself. Thank you especially to my husband. You've stepped in so many ways as a husband and a dad, and I thank you for all of your support. Thank you to my girls, my daughters, your girls, Haley and Cadence. Thank you for all of your love, your hugs, and your sticky notes. It meant the world to me to know that it was the quality of our time and not so much the quantity of our time, especially when I was off doing scholarly things. Thank you. Thank you to my best friend, Michelle, Dr. Michelle McGuire, who has been my friend and my mentor along the way. It's been so wonderful to have you with me. Thank you to all of my family who supported me and kept me sane along the way. We've sacrificed so much and been through so much, and it's meant the world to me. I've also found so much support in my Fielding friends. Our talks have meant the world to me. It's like having my own personal therapist, and I just can't say I can't get through enough without you. Stephanie, you've been there for me a lot, Dr. Olson, and Ellie. I would not have finished my dissertation without them. Everyone, we've just taken it one step at a time this entire way, and we just have to keep taking that step for our journey, and it's just beginning, and I'm so happy to be here with everyone today. Thank you.
I'm so proud, so please join me in welcoming Dr. Susanna Waters into the community of scholars and practitioners.
So I remember when I started this program, somebody said to me that they knew I was an overachiever because I was here. And those words terrified me because I was not an overachiever. But I could envision today standing here, and I knew then that I would be an overachiever when I got up here. And I'm here, and I'm not an overachiever. But what I am is so much better, and that's a supported achiever who's persevered. And I've been supported along the way by my family, my husband Troy, my mom Jan, and my daughter, Madison, who are here, along with my sons, Derek, Austin, and Mason. I've been supported by my dissertation committee, Dr. Fallon, Dr. Green, and Dr. Vivian. And I'm just so thankful for all of the support, and I will continue to receive and need their support as I achieve with this degree and as I go forward. So thank you so much.
It's my pleasure to welcome to the community of scholar practitioners, Dr. Sarah Ray Curat.
Right. Hello, good evening. I did make some cliff notes. I wanted to speak from the heart and in the moment, but I need a few citations, as Dr. Pam would say. But good evening, I am Dr. Sarah Curitan. The running joke is I'm not the kind of doctor that can save your life, but given that I study politics and media and the relationship between them, I don't know that that's entirely true. This is a very strange time to be alive. It's a great time to focus on work and self-care after completing this degree that I started in 2016 and defended in 2021. This moment is celebrated with in mind the moments that got us here when we did want to quit, we didn't believe in ourselves, we didn't think our ideas were good enough, we pushed forward. So this moment is on the mountains of all of those moments. It's a miracle I'm here, weather and health and work aside. I come from a family of hardworking middle-class folks. My mom made it to 10th grade. My dad, my grandfather were union iron workers, and I went to journalism school. I want to thank my family, my supportive friends, a bunch of weirdos and misfits and disruptors who inspire me every day. If you haven't met Chris and Murphy, you will know if you meet them tonight why I say I won the husband and dog lottery. I'm grateful to have great teachers. It's my duty to pay it forward to those teachers now in my own classroom. My high school journalism advisor, Sherry Casillas, my undergrad instructors who were all working press, John Prisby, Joe Schoenman, Michael Squires. In my first graduate program at Gonzaga, Chris Morehouse was the teacher who wore her heart on her sleeve and gave me permission to do the same. Here at Fielding, David Peck and Sean Tennis, I have to do the tennis, you know, skirt. Gary Hare, Dan Sewell, who took a girl who got a D minus in her first college math class to excel and understand doctoral statistics. Jerry Lynn Hogg, Brian Cutler, of course, Dr. Pam Rutledge, who was the rudder of my PhD vessel, the friends, the research partners. Going as far as one can in formal education, now an educator myself in classrooms of my own, I will say the greatest lesson that I have learned is that it's so much more important and quite frankly more joyful to be a learner than a knower. Curiosity creates possibilities where certainty imposes limitations. I vow to never stop learning and growing as long as I live, and I hope to inspire others in any way that I can. So thank you, congratulations, and cheers to this Fielding community.
It's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Jay Grant to the community of scholar practitioners.
Well, I did my homework assignment and I did write it down, but it was on my phone and it didn't bring my reading glasses. So we'll just see how this goes. So first of all, I'm happy to be here and I'm really glad that I'm done. This was a long road, and I realized today that my first day of orientation, my first week of new student orientation was also my daughter's first week of sixth grade, and today we were out looking at colleges for her, so it indeed was a long road. But I'm also happy to be here, at Fielding or within Fielding, however we want to describe that. And I think this was a good opportunity for me just to pay some respect and give some reflection to the institution, which has stretched and, from all of our comments, has really nurtured and nourished us through the time we've been here. And I, for one, am grateful that Fielding was here when I needed it. How lucky was I as a bona fide grown-up to find an academic home that really met my passions. And Fielding delivered the academic rigor, we can all attest to that, and that was what I expected, and that's what I craved. What I hadn't really thought about so much was the community that I was joining, and truly the people of Fielding, the faculty, administrators, and at very key moments, the librarians, made it clear from the beginning that they were on my team. I never for a moment doubted that everyone wanted me to succeed. So as I answer the call to my next career, teaching, the professionalism, but even more so, the compassion and the patience shown by my professors will really serve as a model for the kind of professor I aspire to be. So yes, I'm happy to be here at Fielding, and Fielding has really made a mark on me, and I'm all the better for it.
Tonight, I'm so proud to welcome Dr. Monica Robbins to the community of scholars.
Thank you. So I would like to definitely thank all of my wonderful friends, family, and colleagues for really supporting me when I desperately needed it, but perhaps was too proud to ask for that support. So thank you. Every word of encouragement is a spackle in the cracks that appear. I would also like to thank my dissertation committee, my chair, Dr. Karen Shackelford, Dr. Regina Tuma, Dr. Ellen Cornelius, and Dr. Karen Douglas, for being incredibly supportive while also being rigorous. And that's something that I would like to bring up and actually echo what Dr. Grant has just said. When I mentioned that I was gonna start doing a PhD, everyone always says that's nice, good for you, but the reality is that there's a lot of expectation management that you also hear as a PhD student, because this is a very difficult process. And I read this on the internet, it may not be true, but something like half of people that start doctorates do not finish them. And I think a lot of that has to do with kind of the academic and political shenanigans that tend to go on in this process. I can tell you, however, that in my experience, I saw nothing like that, and I got nothing but incredible support along with that incredible rigor. So I would like to have everyone give a round of applause to the wonderful people on the stage and in the audience who were able to give us both and get us through this. So thank you.
Wrong way. I'm a little.
We're a little height different.
Yeah, well, no. I'm the wrong way. That's all. Wait a minute. Can't see without my glasses, but I got it. Okay.
It is with great honor that I welcome
Dr. Megan Ryan to the community of scholars at Fielding Graduate University. I'm going to miss you.
Hi, Mom. One moment for the paper. All right, so Regina and I are well aware we're the last one before the reception. So thank you for bearing with us. I promise to be brief here. Thank you all for joining us tonight. While I was preparing for the speech, I was reminded of my grandfather, so my pop, and he may be the very first media psychologist I ever met, just for his love of the newspaper. He read it front to back every day, the Star Ledger. So he read that newspaper with the idea that everybody has a story. And with that in mind, you may know that my dissertation focused on social media and storytelling as a means of coping efficacy. We are always making and telling important, meaningful stories. Tonight, you all are a part of my story. So thank you to the Fielding community, to my colleagues, to my dear friends, and to my family. Mom, Dad, Matt, family at home, thank you. It is my honor to stand here tonight. And as we conclude the ceremony, please do me an honor. Tell your story. Remember your loved ones. Make meaningful memories here in beautiful Santa Barbara. Thank you. Cheers.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Wendy Williams. I'm the provost of Fielding Graduate University. And I have the distinction of being in between you and the end of this ceremony, so we will not keep it long. I want to send my deepest congratulations to the class of 2023 and share a small story. It was at a small celebratory dinner with one of our graduates this week that I was inspired by her acknowledgement of the power of the small yes. The first in her family to attend graduate school, it apparently was a small yes in response to a question from her now deceased grandmother that placed her in this room with you, her peers, now holding the title of doctor. What I noted in her comments were that the big yeses are ever apparent. We know their impact will be large, even significant, because the very nature of their question is in fact of that size. But it is the yeses, the small ones, that hold a particular power. They hold power because they are seemingly easy to give or not, yet have immense power to open possibility for not only ourselves, but for others. Each of your stories, some shared today on this stage, articulate the hope, the sacrifice, and the courage required of you to say yes to yourself. Yes, at this age and stage of life, you can go back to school. Yes, you have what it takes to embark on the journey of graduate study, becoming a scholar practitioner, with the capacity to make your mark in the field and impact your communities. Yes, you are of the material from which a doctor is made. And yes, you are now a doctor. Congratulations, School of Psychology class of 2023. We are honored that you began your journey at Fielding and will watch with wonder, support, and pride your next steps. Congratulations.